hello and welcome. You're watching Epicenter on CNN News 18. I'm Maha Siddiqui. The place that stood as a symbol of political resistance in a land war that triggered the demise of the left rule after 34 years in West Bengal is now again back in focus. Nandigram is seeing a fierce clash of personalities. Chief Minister Mamata Banerjee on the one side and her once close confidant, now foe, Shivendu Adhikari on the other. The constituency that polls after 2 days has seen a surcharged atmosphere, but amidst all that hype and headlines, will Nandigram's voice be heard? Is the clash of the titans trumping development? That's the question we are asking this evening on Epicenter. But before we get to the debate, our senior editor Pallavi Ghosh's report from Ground Zero for a primer on the subject.
In 2011, these fields and roads in Nandigram propelled Mamata Banerjee to power. Today, it's the same Nandigram which will play a decisive role in her political future. This Shahid Minar is a testimony to the turmoil that Nandigram has seen. The 2007 agitation, which killed more than 50 people, in which many women and children were assaulted, is etched in the memory of Duan Khan. He lost his 9-year-old child in the police firing.
উল্টো আহ্বান করে যখন আসতে চেষ্টা করে তখন জনসাধারণ তার প্রতিরোধ করার চেষ্টা করে সেই সময়ই পুলিশ গুলি চালায় পরে কিছু গুলি হারমাদদের ভিতর থেকেও কিছু গুলি আসে মানে ওই পুলিশের সঙ্গে তারা ছিল সেই গুলিতে প্রাথমিক স্টেজে কয়েকজনকে লাগে তারপরে পরপর ক্ষেত্রবিশেষে যত পুলিশ এগিয়ে আসছে গুলি করতে করতে এগিয়ে আসছে সেই সময় বাকি 14 জন মারা যায়।
It's been fairly peaceful after that. No factories have come up, but there has been tranquility. That could be shattered now because of the high decibel campaigns of Mamata Banerjee and her right-hand man turned rival Shivendu Adhikari.
মানে এগুলো সব সরিয়ে
আমাদের কত
26টা
মোজা 26টা মোজা না বেশি
এইগুলো কোনো ফাঁকা জায়গা নয় আমি বলছিলাম কি যে কিছু জায়গা পড়ে আছে সেখানে করুক কি আমাদের কিছু অসুবিধা নেই
It's a do or die poll for Mamata Banerjee. So much so that she has rented a home here. On the other hand, Shivendu Adhikari has to prove to the BJP that his entry has its own value. The polarization is near complete, and Mamata Banerjee hopes that 49% voters and minorities will swing it for her.
It's this area over here in Nandigram which was trying to be snatched away for building up of an SEZ. Today it becomes a battleground once again as Shivendu Adhikari, who's been seen as a protege of Mamata Banerjee, is now pitted opposite her. She promises to fight back with a huge margin. The battle is on, or as the TMC and the BJP are saying, khela hobe. With N. Satish in Nandigram, Pallavi Ghosh.
In fact, Pallavi Ghosh is now joining us live as well from Nandigram. Pallavi, apart from development, is security and smooth conduct of elections now also top of the mind for people in Nandigram with the kind of political animosity that is playing out on the ground?
Absolutely, Maha. And it's a high-stake election, both for Mamata Banerjee, the Trinamool Congress, because after all, the sitting chief minister is contesting from there. And of course, also for Shivendu Adhikari and the BJP, because it's now become a battle of prestige. For Shivendu Adhikari, it's become to show that a four-time MLA can come and defeat a sitting CM, which would actually be seen as a huge feat. And for Mamata Banerjee, the genesis of the Ma Mati Manush slogan actually began from Singur as well as Nandigram, and she needs to win that seat. After it be a huge political kind of a setback for her should she lose from Nandigram. And given the high stakes, naturally there's a lot of tension on the ground, Maha, and the TMC workers as well as the BJP workers. Even when I've been traveling to Nandigram, I've been seeing lots of tense moments between the two of them, which is why the election commission is very worried. The tempers may be frayed, and therefore there's a possibility that peace may be disrupted. So the maximum number of security officials on the ground, the central observers deployed by the Election Commission, and actually be seen in Nandigram as well. But it has also now become a political issue. Mamata Banerjee is now accusing the BJP of getting people from outside, from the BJP rule states like Uttar Pradesh and Bihar, to benefit the BJP's talk as far as Nandigram goes. An allegation which has, of course, completely been rejected both by the BJP as well as by the Election Commission.
All right, Pallavi, many thanks for joining us with all those details from Nandigram. So clearly, this political animosity that we are seeing on the ground, is it trumping the issue of development, which should be crucial in any election? That's the big question we are asking our guests this evening. Let me introduce our guests who will be joining us on the show. Shikha Mukherjee, senior journalist, is with us on the line at the moment. Shikha, coming to you first of all, the question of development, you know, it certainly appears that that has taken a backseat when these two personalities clash, and all that we are hearing about is Shuvendu Adhikari or Mamata Banerjee and nothing beyond that really.
Well, I think there are two issues here. One is that the perception is that there is no other conversation, and especially about development. But it is also true that Mamata Banerjee in her public meetings is making a point on development. What is even more important is that the Samyukt Morcha is leading a campaign which is focused entirely on development. And then in on the wider perspective, the politics within which India, the political crisis in India at this point in time. Therefore, development is missing from the election campaign. That is not exactly true. What is happening is the Mamata versus Shubhendu, Mamata versus Amit Shah, Mamata versus Modi, that is getting foregrounded, and the critical issues of development, which is what a state election is all about. Basically, the people have certain aspirations and how the government intends to fulfill them in the next 5 years. So Mamata Banerjee has a manifesto, and that is what she is talking about, as well as her past record. Of that, the one issue that has been selectively isolated is the issue of industrialization and employment through jobs through the process of industrial investment. The other parts of her development agenda have not even been addressed by the BJP, as it were.
All right. So let's get in the BJP spokesperson here. Shatrupa is joining us from West Bengal. Now, Shatrupa, how would you respond to what Shikha is saying about the issue of jobs, about the issue of industrialization? Because today, even a comment that has been made by Buddhadev Bhattacharjee, the former chief minister, suggests that this is the silence of a graveyard that has engulfed Nandigram and Shingur, suggesting that it is unlikely to see any development when there is this clash of personalities that's taking place.
See, it is most unfortunate when I was listening to the end of what Madam Shikha was saying. It is most unfortunate that an election has to revolve around personalities, and you know, the development is forgotten, which people have not forgotten actually. This is our perception. People are the ones who are living this lack of development every single day. The fact that they voted in a government in the hope of a parivartan, in the hope of a big change, for a huge development, and Mamata Banerjee had come to power on making a tremendous amount of promises for a new Bengal, industrialization. Industrialization was never her priority. She chased away Tata from Shingur. But then there have been no jobs except those 100 days jobs that she keeps giving to her, Trinamool cadres and their family members. And all we keep seeing them doing is painting the same bridge over and over again, blue and white.
So Shatrupa, take us through what the BJP is offering. You have pointed out what the TMC has not done, what Mamata Banerjee has not done. What is it that the BJP is offering? Because this particular place, Nandigram, is the one that has seen this fight over land acquisition. Do you think that it is possible to bring industrialization, development, jobs growth in an area which has resisted the path of industrialization?
It actually has not. Nobody in Bengal in reality has resisted the path of industrialization except the Honorable Chief Minister and her party. Now, you wanted me to take you through the BJP manifesto. which very briefly I will do this. It's such a long manifesto, such a lovely manifesto. It will take some 10 shows to complete it. I will just take you through the major highlights. Yes, we have talked about improving the lot of every single person in West Bengal, whether it's women, whether it's children, whether it's industrialization, whether it's agriculture, whether it's industry hubs, whether it's jute, whether it's cotton, whether it's mulberry silk, whether it's Bengal culture, whether it's Bengal ethos, Bengal language, which has now come to a derogatory low because of what the Chief Minister is keeping on and on hurling at the BJP leaders, even the Honorable Prime Minister. We have touched on every single aspect. We at BJP do not make false promises. You have seen us in the central government. You have seen us in the number of governments that we've been forming at the state levels. We will deliver a proper Shonar Bangla, the Bengal that we have been dreaming of ever since the time that Vivekananda went from here to Chicago, ever since Rabindranath Tagore won the Nobel laureate, ever since Bengal has begun dreaming. You see, Bengal has never really got what it wanted. Bengal has given India the maximum number of freedom fighters. I do not mean to demean any other state. Bengal has its own pride, and Bengal has not seen what it deserves to see.
All right.
Since the CPM last 34 years, and then Trinamool for the last 10 years, we have only seen steady decadence.
All right. And decadence let's take that point with the spokesperson of the Trinamool Congress. Suparna Moitra is also joining us here on the show. Suparna, how would you respond to that?
Friend.
That 10 years down the line, the BJP says that the state of West Bengal, and if I talk particularly about Nandigram, because we are discussing only in the context of Nandigram today, it has barely seen any development. That's the allegation by the BJP.
Good evening, Ms. Siddiqui, and good evening to all the fellow panelists. Now, I will tell you the last 10 years, when we came to power in 2011, there was huge debt servicing on our heads, and we are still doing that huge amount of debt servicing. So that continues.
It doesn't look like it. The number of hala and mela that keeps happening in our state,
would it
repaying any debts.
Would it be so proper that I kept quiet and I listened to everyone? And I think I would request that BJP spokesperson to show that sort of a tolerance when I'm speaking.
Sure.
One.
Sure, go ahead.
Two, what the infrastructure was also at its lowest ebb post the 34-year left rule. We have worked on that. Three, we believe in the welfare mechanism, and that's an article of faith for us. So the programs and the schemes that we did was to ensure that the poorest sections of the people economically marginalized, the vulnerable sections of the society.
It didn't happen. Where did it happen? Give us examples.
Shatrupa, just a second. Let Suparna Moitra finish, and then yes, go ahead.
What is this? I heard about all those things about BJP. Now let us talk. Ms. Shatrupa, please allow us to talk.
Go ahead.
So we did. Thank you. So all the programs were for economic empowerment and lift and bringing the poor and the marginalized into the mainstream. Then let me also tell you about the land acquisition. You asked a very good question to the BJP representative. Let me state our position.
Okay.
One.
Okay.
We are not going to. When we come to power, we leave it to the people to decide on that. But when we come to power, and if we come to power, our stance with regard to land acquisition would remain the same. We are not going to forcibly acquire land from anybody.
All right. All right. We will leave this issue at this juncture, Suparna Moitra, because we'll also quickly listen in to what Mamata Banerjee had to say while campaigning. Today was the last day of campaigning for that constituency, and she spoke with Shokto Mukhopadhyay. Let's quickly listen in to her, and then we'll talk about the issue of why there is polarization on the ground in Nandigram. If development is the real issue, then why polarize the voters? We'll talk about that, but before that, here's a quick look at Shokto's report.
The Trinamool Congress workers' family have been reportedly injured in political clashes in Nandigram in the days past. And you can see Mamata Banerjee right here. You can see Mamata Banerjee actually, talking to these Trinamool Congress supporters, workers, and you can see actually the elderly people who are who have come.
Ja da da mata ra sahab didi boshe jao didi boshe jao
security and asking the security election commission I will submit the election commission this is a Bolorampur village and this is a Bolorampur village and BJP workers are beating them her husband is in coma he is in coma
are ye nahi chhoda na
they are beating them like anything so they want the security I will request the election commission give them security how they will vote what is the previous fair election give them security first.
And now let's talk about the one aspect that has been highlighted today by none other than the former chief minister of West Bengal, Buddhadev Bhattacharjee. He's saying that on the ground in Nandigram, animosity is being created between communities because of this election. So let's try and understand why this polarization is actually happening in Nandigram. Of course, this is a high stakes battle that is playing out in that particular constituency, considering the two people who are contesting this election. Mamata Banerjee on the one side, Shivendu Adhikari, her former confidant turned foe, on the other side from the BJP. So this constituency, if we divide it roughly into block 1 and block 2, we are seeing a 34% minority population in block 1 and a 12% minority population in block 2. So in block 1, it is apparently advantage the Trinamool Congress. But Trinamool Congress must win 30+% votes in block 2 as well, which is the majority votes as well. For the BJP, they have to maximize whatever they can in block 2. And that is why we are seeing some bit of dog whistle politics campaign also being carried out by Shivendu Adhikari there, all in a bid, in fact, to polarize. But let's go back to our guests on this crucial issue that we are seeing at the moment. Shubhana Moitro, first of all, is Mamata Banerjee and the fact that she is also constantly visiting temples now, and we've just pointed out through these graphics why the majority votes here will be important for her. Is she being forced to toe an agenda that has been set by the BJP, and is that betraying a sense of underconfidence?
She is a nominee for which the elections are going to take place on the 1st of April. And there were a lot of religious shrines, be it from the majority community or the other religious sort of shrines. She's visiting all because they are in that given geography. So she is not visiting them because she needs to prove a point or we are playing into the hands of a party which believes and advocates majoritarianism. Certainly not. As I said, that the inclusive aspect is an article of faith for us, and we are going to be remaining glued to that only, Ms. Siddiqui.
All right. Let me go across to another guest who's joining us, Professor Dinesh Varshne, leader of the CPI. Professor Varshne, Buddhadev Bhattacharya feels that animosity is being created on the ground in Nandigram because of this high-stakes battle, and he's calling Mamata Banerjee and Shivendu Adhikari co-conspirators. What is the sense that the left parties are trying to send out? Are you trying to get even for what happened 10 years ago when the left parties lost power in West Bengal?
Look, Comrade Buddhadev Bhattacharya, what has said is correctly. It is absolutely correct. I tell you how. Look, when the Nandigram movement happened, now it has become ample clear that the TMC and BJP are accusing each other that it has been caused by their movement. And it is their man, and it is their man who brought it direct and not allowed the youth of the Bengal to take the job because of the industrialization of the Nandigram area. Now, they are communalizing the entire election, and TMC and BJP are equally responsible. Reason being, TMC is responsible for the advent of BJP in Bengal, not the left. And similarly, the BJP is trying to communalize the election, which is always their election plank, so that even they wanted to communalize the election in Tamil Nadu, in Bengal, in Puducherry, everywhere.
Okay.
Because their Communal card is the biggest tool of elections.
So let's get a response from Shatrupa on that. Shatrupa, you just heard Professor Varshne, you've heard Buddhadev Bhattacharjee as well, the former chief minister, saying that the environment of communal amity, which was the pride of Bengal, has been turned poisonous. Is this a direct attack on the BJP? How do you respond to this?
So they are always attacking. Thank you for letting me in. Thanks. They are always attacking BJP on the basis that we are creating communal riots. But if you look back at the history of Bengal over the last 44 years, 34 years of the left and 10 years of Srinamool, you will see that they are constantly on the path of appeasement. They do not think of a particular community, and they're all the time trying to please one particular community. In fact, Mamata Banerjee has even been saying that the Muslims are her Dudhel Goru, which means a cow.
But Shatrupa, this attack is coming from the left parties.
I'm very sorry.
Buddhadev Bhattacharjee has said this.
I'm very sorry. She is wrong. Never in the left rule the communalism is allowed. Never in the left rule the appeasement politics.
All right. I'll hold both of you there. Just a second. Just a second, ma'am. And Dinesh Vash, Professor Bhattacharjee. Just a second. Shatrupa, I want to bring in Aman Sharma, senior editor, who's joining us live from Nandigram. I'll come back to you, ma'am. Aman, what I want to know from you is this polarization that we're seeing in Nandigram new to this constituency? What are people on the ground telling you?
People on the ground say this kind of polarization has never been seen in this constituency ever earlier. To understand Nandigram, if you put it in context, there are about 2.75 lakh voters in Nandigram. Out of that, about 70,000 is minority population. Hmm. And it essentially divided into two blocks. There is block one and there is block two. Block two, which has a higher proportion of minority population, which Mamata Banerjee considers to be her stronghold, the TMC stronghold. And block two, which is a lower proportion of Muslim population, higher Hindu population, which BJP, Shivendu Mukherjee, is appealing to the people that this is his stronghold.
Okay.
So if you see today, Amit Shah's campaign was in block number two, while Mamata was campaigning in block number one entire day. So this is the constituency's profile. So this has been the profile for long. But the thing is, this time, for the first time, the appeal for votes or the appeal to the people is being made on this polarization line, because BJP thinks it can win the election if Hindu consolidation on this seat happens.
All right.
So that is why, you see statements like Shivendu calling Mamata as Begum, or, saying that a community celebrates here when Pakistan wins a cricket match. And Mamata Banerjee is doing equally, like the same kind of attacks on Shivendu Mukherjee, Shivendu Adhikari, calling Amir Jafar a Gaddar or of a party which is wanted to create riots. So the atmosphere which I found on the ground amongst the people is very, very polarized.
Okay.
The Hindu consolidation, the Hindu voter, in the villages which are more Hindu dominated, are towards the BJP. They want to give BJP a chance because, ultimately the question is also development of this area. This is an area where you find broken roads. If you see Amit Shah's roadshow today from where it began, you see the condition of that bridge. It looked as if, that bridge looked so dilapidated.
Okay.
So, there is no development clearly which has come to this area for very long. People want a change. People want, but so far Mr. Adhikari was the MLA. So Mamata is now accusing Mr. Adhikari of poor development in the area while she was the CM herself.
All right. So that's a bit of an irony that is also playing out. Aman, we'll have to leave it at that, Aman, because I quickly need to take some closing comments from our guests on the show. Let me go back to Shatrupa because she wanted to make a point. Yeah. Shatrupa, very quickly, I'll be able to give you 30 seconds and also respond to what Aman just told us about what he's picking up from the ground, that this is the first time that constituency is seeing polarization of this nature.
Thank you. I will quickly respond to what your CPM leader was saying. Pardon me, I've forgotten his name. Just let me remind you of three incidents. If you look at the history of Bengal, you will understand. There is an incident which happened at Marichchapi, which was an island where refugees from Bangladesh were invited and kept on the promise of being given citizenship of a proper livelihood. These people burnt Marichchapi. CPM burnt Marichchapi, and there was not a soul left on the human beings were burnt alive on an island. Number two incident, Shaibari, where a little girl, little child
this
was
is also
killed,
this
murdered
is
brutally, and his mother was made to have.
She's lying. She's lying. The facts.
I am
all
not
right.
lying. Look at the look
Shatrupa,
at the history.
You are lying.
Because
the facts.
Okay, I'm going to interrupt both of you because Shatrupa, I have given you 30 seconds. 30 seconds, you're running out of time. Let me take a quick closing comment there from Shikha Mukherjee, who's been very patiently hearing all of you out. Just a second. Just a second, both of you. Shikha Mukherjee, I want to come to you for the closing comments here, and I can give you 30 seconds only. Are we seeing this polarization for the first time in Nandigram? That is what our senior editor who's on the ground is telling us. Does this does this not augur well for a state of West Bengal where Buddhadev Bhattacharjee Singh has, you know, Bengali culture has seen no animosity between communities?
Yes, exactly. Nandigram is the battleground, is the war zone which will define the communal polarization and the relationship between the two communities going forward. And it is very, very important that we recognize that that the 30% Muslim vote that the BJP says it is not going to even get means that the BJP does not represent that 30% for a democracy, for a diverse, communally diverse democracy. This exclusion is essentially injuring the character of the state as enshrined in the constitution and the nation as it was created through a long process.
And does this also push the agenda of development to the back burner when there is a personality clash, when there is polarization on the ground? Is this an easy way to shift focus away from development? That is something that is of concern here. And ultimately, it's the people of Nandigram, the voters of Nandigram, who will decide on the 1st of April, seal their decision in the EVMs. And we'll hear about that on the 2nd of May. Many thanks to all four of our guests for joining us here on the show. And thanks to our reporters as well for getting us the very latest. We're taking a very quick break now. News and updates will continue. Stay with us.